Now we are going to understand the numerical part of our chapter called work and energy. So first numerical here we have, okay, it says calculate the work done to take an object of mass 20 kg. So it is the given part, so we have to write first given. So whenever we are going to solve, first we have to write the given part. So given, what is given? Mass of an object. So I'm writing here mass of an object. Okay, it is given 20 kg. Okay, to the height of 10 meter, and height is also given. We have to take that object at a height of 10 meter. Okay, that height is nothing but the displacement. And here it is given g, it is acceleration due to gravity. It is given 9.8 meter per square second. Okay, so see, the question says, suppose here we have the earth surface, here we have any object of mass 20 kg, and we had to move or that take that object up to the meter of up to the height of 10 meter from here, from the surface, is it? So we have to calculate that work done when this 20 kg of object is taken 10 meter of height above the earth surface. Okay, everyone?
Okay, sir.
So here we are pushing that object opposite to the gravity. Is it? That means when we are applying force in that direction, gravitational force is opposing to our force, is it? That means we had to take value of g negative here because it is opposing force. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So here, first we had to calculate the force because force is not given. So first we had to calculate force, and then if we will calculate the force, we have mass. Okay, then we can easily calculate the work done. So I'm just writing here to find what we had to find, the work done. So we had to calculate work, so it is equals to question mark. Now formula. So for work done we have formula, it is F W equals to F into S. S means the displacement, which is given for that particular question, it is 10 meter. We have to calculate force first. So for force, we have formula, it is mass into acceleration, means mass into acceleration due to gravity, mg. So now we are going to solve. So first we are going to calculate the force.
Sir, someone is in waiting room.
Wait a second. Yes, Diksha is in waiting room. Diksha, welcome, beta. Diksha, am I audible, Diksha?
Yes, sir.
Welcome, beta. Welcome. We are doing the chapter called work and energy, and we are covering the numerical part today. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Sorry. I'm suffering with little cough and cold. So in between I'll cough. So don't bother about it. Okay. So first we have to calculate the force because, sorry, because it is not given. So for force, we have formula. It is mass into gravity. So force equals to mass is given of an object which is 20 kg. So I'm writing here 20 kg into gravity is also, acceleration due to gravity is also given. And which is, see, we are taking magnitude negative because it is opposing force, no? So that's why it is negative 9.8 meter per second square. If we will multiply that, so we will get F equals to C. 2 8s are 16. So 16 will have 6 year and 1 will carry year. 2 9s are 18 and 1 19. So we have 196. Okay, and that 0 here. So 196.0. And here we have negative sign and that mass is positive. So we will get negative here. So now we got the force which is negative 196. Okay. And that kg meter per second square will be equals to the Newton. So I am writing here Newton. Okay. Everyone understood?
Yes, sir. Understood.
Okay. Okay. So now we have force also. We have displacement also. So we can easily calculate the work done. So I'm just calculating work done here. Now work. So we have formula. What is formula for work? It is W equals to, here we have already written here, force into displacement. So I'm writing here W equals to F into S. So W equals to, what is F force? It is negative 196 into, and the displacement is 10. So if you will multiply, we will get negative 1960. Okay. And see here it is Newton meter. So Newton meter is what? It is joule. We already gone through in last class. Okay. So here we have work done is 1960 joule of work is going to perform by that object in order to lift that 20 kg object above the earth surface at the height of 10 meter. Okay. Now we have answer here. So now we have to write the result. So result now. So what will be the result? The work done will be, okay. See, that work cannot be negative. That means that negative sign represent it is negative work done. Why? Because we are moving that object opposite to the gravity. Okay. That's why sign is negative here. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the work done by the work done will be 1960 joule, and negative sign represents okay, what it represents? The direction of force is opposite to the direction of displacement. Okay, means it is negative work done. Negative sign represents the direction of force is opposite to the direction of displacement. Okay, so this is all about the solution. Understood, everyone? Sriyanvi, got
yes,
the
sir.
Question?
Beta? Yes, sir, understood.
Okay,
understood,
so take a screenshot. So we are going to solve the next question, and again it is very important. Second question. Question says, Praveen has applied the force of 100 Newton. See, force is already given here, and which is 100 Newton. So I'm just writing the given part. Given. What is given? The force applied by the Praveen, and which is 100 Newton. Of an object at the angle of 60 degree. See, the value of theta is also given. So theta is of 60 degree. Okay. At a horizontal. So that means we have this is the surface. Here we have an object, and Praveen is standing over here, okay, and he is applying the force in this direction. Okay, that means the direction and a displacement having angle of 60 degree. Understood? Everyone, understood, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The object get displaced in the horizontal direction, and the 400 joule work is done by the Praveen. So work is also given. W equals to it is 400 joule. What is the displacement of the object? So we had to find. So we had to write to find part. To find that we have to calculate. Okay, what we had to find? Displacement means S we had to calculate. Now formula. Which formula we are going to use? W equals to Fs into cos theta. Is it? Now we are going to solve.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So, solution. Okay. So, again, see, we had to calculate the displacement. So, I'm just going to transfer force and cos theta to other side. So, S will be W divide by, see, that force and cos theta will going to be in division because they are in multiple form. So according to the transfer rule, multiple form will going to in division form. So it will become W divide by F into cos theta. Okay, so now we have to place the values now. S equals to work done. We have 400 joule. So I'm writing here 400 joule divided by force is of 100 Newton. So I'm writing here 100 into. Then we have cos theta. See, cos 60 degree. So theta we have what? It is 60 degree. So I'm writing here cos 60 degree. See here, this 20 and 20 will get cancelled. So we have now S equals to 4 divided by the value of cos 60 is given already here. It is 1 by 2 beta. So I'm writing here 4 divided by 1 divided by 2. Okay. So see here, we have that division here, denominator is fraction. So whenever the denominator is fraction, then we had to transfer here in multiple form, where numerator converts into denominator and denominator converts into numerator. So it will become 4 by 1 into 1 by 2 will become 2 by 1. So S equals to 4 twos are 8. Okay. So now we have S means the displacement and which is of 8 meter. Okay. So here we got the answer also. So we have to write result now. Result. So what will be the result? The displacement of an object is 8 meter. Okay, so this is the solution for the given question. Understood, everyone? Any
yes,
doubt?
Sir.
Any doubt here?
No, sir.
Okay, so again, take a screenshot. Now we are going to solve the third question. Again, it is very important. So first, we have to understand the question. Ravi applied a force of 10 Newton. So force is already given. So we had to write given part. Given. What is given? The force. It is of 10 Newton. And moved a book 30 centimeter in the direction of force. That means here we have a book. Okay. And here we have the surface and Ravi applied force of 10 Newton in this direction. And this is the book. And book is moving in this direction and the distance of 30 centimeter from here to here. It is 30 centimeter. See here. The distance means the S and which is of 30 centimeter. We had to convert that centimeter into meter. So that day we have already gone through that 100 centimeter equals to 1 meter. So in order to convert 30 centimeter into meter, we had to divide 30 by 100. Okay. So 30 by 100 will be 0.3 meter. Is it everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So 30 centimeter is equals to 0.3 meter because here if we are using SI unit, so here also we have to use SI, not CGS one. Or else we can convert that Newton into erg. That we'll do also. But we have, it is easy to convert centimeter into meter. So we have converted centimeter into meter now. So 30 centimeter equals to 0.3 meter. How much the work done by Ravi? Okay, so see here, direction and the displacement have the same way, means at 0 degree. That means the cos theta's value will be cos 0 degree and cos 0 will be 1. So if we'll multiply anything by 1, it is not going to change the value. That's why we are not considering this time the cos theta. Okay. So the formula will be, no, we have to write first the to find part. To find. What we had to find? We have to find the work done. So W equals to question mark. Again, formula. So formula will be, it is W equals to F into S. We are using that formula when the direction of applied force and displacement are in the same direction. Okay, then we are using that formula. Otherwise, if it is in any different angle, then we have to multiply or use here cos theta. Here we can also use cos theta, but this theta will be here 0. So cos 0 will be 1. Okay, so cos theta, if theta's value is going to be 1, 0 degree, so its value is 1. So if we are going to use that or not, it is going to be same. So we are not using here. So because condition is given here, no? Because direction of force and the displacement are the same. Okay, that's why we can use only Fs equals to W. So now we are going to solve the question. Solution. So we have work done equals to force into displacement. So W equals to force. Force is of 10 Newton into displacement is of 0.3 meter. So if we will multiply that, we will get 3 Newton meter. And Newton meter is what? It is joule. So we can write W equals to 3 joule. Understood everyone? So here we got the result answer. So we have to write the result now. So I'm just going to write the result here. Result will be what? The work done by Ravi. The work done by Ravi is 3 joule. Okay, when the 10 Newton of force is applied and 30 centimeter of displacement takes place, then the work done will be 3 joules. So take a screenshot, everyone.
Done, sir.